everyone. My name is Ruth Liliana, and I have eosinophilic esophagitis, also known as EOE, and for some people, EE. And I absolutely love my doctor. His name's Dr. Altawil at GI for Kids, and he is amazing. He gave me some really good guidelines for the foods that I can eat, and I can eat delicious foods every day without my stomach hurting at all, and without my EOE acting up. So if you recently found out you have EOE or your child has EOE and you're kinda in a panic, don't worry at all, cause I have EOE and I eat delicious foods that don't make my EOE act up at all every single day. This evening, I'm going to be making a turkey burrito skillet. So I have all my ingredients here. I have fresh zucchini, tomato, red bell pepper, extra virgin organic olive oil, green onions. This is my homemade taco seasoning. In it is cumin, garlic powder, chili powder, and onion powder. This is our homemade red enchilada sauce. It's made with mild chilies, onion, tomatoes, garlic, Mexican oregano, marjoram, not margarine, marjoram. Kids with EOE are not supposed to have margarine, and olive oil. Step one is the mise en place. The mise en place is pretty much having everything together. My mom calls it something different, but I kind of forget. Anyway, the second rule is to always wash your hands. I've already done that with a really good soap. Third thing to do is wash the vegetables, which is what we're gonna do right now. Be right back. Next, we're going to be chopping the vegetables. So you're probably a little bit surprised that I'm only 9 and I'm chopping. Well, my mom's been working with me for a long time, and I have these safety gloves that are tested to where a person held the knife, squeezed as hard as they could, and there was no pain. So I think they're pretty good.
Plus, you're really careful.
Plus, I'm really careful. So the first thing we're gonna be chopping is the zucchini. I like to get everything else out of my way when I'm chopping. First, we're going to cut off the ends. I like to just move them aside and then I'll get them and throw them away later. Okay, so what I've basically done is cut it in half lengthwise and then cut it again in half lengthwise. So basically, we have quarters. Next, we're going to be dicing them like this. I have my zucchini here chopped. Now it's time for the pepper. With peppers, you have to be pretty careful because they are a round shape. Whew. I just washed my hands real quick. Now I'm taking out the ribs of the pepper and putting it in my garbage bowl because to me, having the garbage can open all the time is just gross. You want to make sure you get all the seeds out. Now I've got my zucchini cut and I've got most of the seeds out, but a tip to getting all the seeds out is just giving a little pop. Now I'm ready to cut my peppers in a 3/4 inch dice. Now that the peppers are done, we can move on to the tomato, which we need to core, which means you need to cut it in half and get all the seeds out and put it in the trash bowl. With the tomato, you have to be really careful when you're cutting it because it can roll all around and then the knife may come off and cut your hand off. So, you know. Next, we're going to cut off the stems. And cut the tomatoes in a half inch dice. I'm putting on my gloves and I've discarded the end of the onions that we don't really want to use. And now we're going to thinly slice the parts of the green onion we want to use. Here we have the green onions, thinly sliced green onions. Here is the thinly sliced, chopped zucchini. Here is the chopped bell peppers. Here is the taco seasoning. Here is the tomatoes, chopped tomatoes. Here's the extra virgin olive oil, organic. And here is the enchilada sauce. Here is the turkey, but I didn't really want to get that close to all the other stuff because I didn't want to cross-contaminate. Now it's time to cook. Okay, so we're going to start off with turning the skillet on about medium-high heat and adding about 2 teaspoons of olive oil in. I'm just gonna eyeball it, so it'll be about 1 cupful. We're gonna wait until the pan gets hot until we start adding the ingredients. Okay, now since my pan's good and hot, it's time to add in the red bell peppers. Oh, I love the sound of sizzles. The turkey. There we go. And the taco seasoning. We're going to be stirring occasionally until it gets nice and brown, which is also about 4 to 6 minutes. Make sure you get the meat good and chopped up. Loud noise, guys. You want to make sure and get it into really little pieces. Smell-o-vision, it smells so good. The dish I'm making is gluten-free, celiac-free, and dairy-free. It's great. Go. Now we're going to add the green zucchini.
Green zucchini?
Half of the green onions. I always like to do it with my hands just in case it pours out too much. We're saving the rest for garnish. And a pinch of pepper. Just what? Now the zucchini is cooked al dente, which is firm and soft. Next, we're going to be adding the enchilada sauce. Make sure you get all of it out of there. Stir until heated and then turn off the heat. So about 1 minute. Now I'm ready to plate my dish. It's pretty simple for me. All I have to do is scoop some of the food right in the bowl, with the exception of the garnish. For garnish, I'm going to add the green onions and the tomatoes. Voila! Bon appetit! Believe it or not, there are still people who eat dairy, like my dad. So for him, I made some variations. I added some sour cream, some cheddar cheese, and some tortilla chips, with the exception of tomatoes and scallions. They're perfect. Just remember, all the cool kids hang out in dairy-free land. Doesn't that look just delicious? I'll be back with more recipes. I hope you enjoyed this video. Bye.